following me and stuff. Because I'm just having a lot of problems with Twitch. Not all technical, but yeah, I just don't feel like I'm growing fast enough over there. So, for many reasons, I'm mostly trying to focus on Beam.pro. It also has a much faster... It has much faster delay times, or much lower delay times. So, you know, even though I, you know, will say something, I can hear it maybe 2 seconds later. I'll respond to chat faster. Overall, Beam.pro seems to be a much better experience. Okay, I honestly don't know where things left off on the stream. Alright, in our 3D widget, we came in here, we did our ray trace, we did all bunches of magic, and then we put it into something new that we created in our UI. So, all this, you know, techno mumble jumbo is transferring locations, and then we get to here. Alright. So let's get back to where we were. Alright, now here, it looks like we're just breaking the vector. And then we're making a 2D vector. 2D vector. Out of these guys. And let's see. My cursor. Get. Set render transform. Oh no, translation. To there. So maybe I misunderstood, but you know, it could be that, you know, these mesh are not here at all. You're not supposed to see them ever. In which case, I don't know why we have visibility. So let's just delete that completely. You gotta really admire fan music sometimes. Occasionally, it's better than the original. And I think this is one of those times. Okay, so if I did this correctly, and I think I did, let me double check.
So what this previous code did was we get a line trace, and we see if it hits the menu.
Alrighty. I gotta kill Mubot. Oh? Oh, are you talking about the shadow problem out here? The reflection issue? I'm all ears. Because I tried switching to cube map and it did nothing. Alright. I'm gonna... Alrighty. Alright, so there's that. So you're saying if I got rid of actually I only have yeah, this is not, this is like a, actually atmospheric fog. Let's delete that. Still there. Let's turn visible off. Let's turn that, which is, yeah. If I go that to movable, it goes away. I have no idea why that is. But if it's stationary or static, it causes an issue. So it's definitely this. recapture? No. Yeah, I can't do movable. I'd love to. I'll do static. So, you know, building should fix it, but haven't noticed it. Sky distance threshold. All right, it's baked, and it's still there. What about cast shadows and effects world? I doubt that'll do anything, but you never know. All right, that's still causing the sphere. It's just now I don't see it. In fact, let me just see about... Let's save this real quick. Delete. Build. All right, the problem's still there. Let me remove the reflections. And then let's remove that too. Let's see. So there's only... the distant light. And let's remove that. So all that's left are the lightsabers. So if I build now, the world should be in black. Blackness. All right. Oh God, this could be fantastic. All right, let's see. Oh God, this would be a fantastic level. I definitely gotta do this.
Where'd he go? Where is he?
I don't know.
Ah!
Oh, that could be hilariously awesome. But this is just the test demo area. So let's just drop in a directional light. Intensity of 1. Oh no, let's set that to 5. And I like a skylight in there. We'll set it to static though. And let's see. Alright. Lighting needs to be rebuilt. Yeah, I definitely want to do a... Okay, yeah. Okay, that's still there. Delete that. Okay, so maybe it's this. Oh, I did. But for some reason, what images? Oh, you think it's these guys? The VR pawn? Yeah, I tried that. All right. Rebuilt. And look, they're still there. I gotta get a movement function in here. All right. All right, let's build again. This way I can actually see, I just have to turn around. All right, well, we're just doing play and editor at the moment. Yeah, still there. So I'm just going to reset this, and you're right. It could be, you know, an editor thing, since we are doing play in editor. So let's do standalone. Come on. There we go. No. Damn it. Hide that. And... oh, I don't know how to... let's see. Stereo on. Nope. Not getting a damn thing. What you see is... apparently, I don't know how to do a standalone game as, wait, where'd it go? Ah. It crashed or something, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know how to do a, standalone, play in VR. So I'll have to look that up, and I'll definitely give that another look. But you know, it definitely looks like it's, you know, this thing. So maybe there's, you know, something here. Well, light shaft occlusion, distance field, dynamic shadows. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything. Show engine, sky. Now I will have to eventually make my own skybox. Yeah. I'll definitely look that up in between streams. Alright, visual effects, exponential height fog. What, is that, or do I want atmospheric? Yeah, we'll start with atmospheric. Yeah. Well, I'll also see if I can't find out what's going on with, you know, the out-of-editor build, and see if I can't fix that. But, you know, I don't plan on doing too many planet-side stuff, so long as this isn't happening in the, game, yeah, you know, the main part of the game, you know, we can probably build around it in some ways. This is just my initial test map, so. Alrighty. So let's get back to our menu. Where did I leave off? Oh yeah, need to come in here. Okay, style, normal, hover, pressed. Okay, where was that guy's video? Oh yeah, there it is.
If it does, we set our cursor to the hit location. And...
ah, here it is. Okay, so we're going back to the VR editor. Back to the players! And in this case, we're actually jumping out and We need to come down here to Saber Action. So Saber Left, because now we're down here to Menu Interaction. And it looks like we want to check Trace Menu Hit. Bless. All right, so from here, reroute. Actually, yeah, we got return nodes. I can just do a return node. Return.
What we do next is if we pull the trigger on the backside here, the left trigger use.
Alright, so VR widget. Get is valid. All right, so
we check if our menu was hit. If it was, we check.
All right, so. So now we need to do a 3D menu widget function, because I'm looking ahead a little. All right. Trigger, let's see. Menu item press. Alright, so menu item pressed. Return. That wasn't too hard. In fact, I can just copy that, compile. Good, it does work. And now I can go to Saber button right. Paste down here. And we'll just put that right there. And we got to make sure that this is all set to the right hand stuff. Actually, I think that's just it. Yeah, that looks better than the other way. Oh, you got a second art test? Because I know you got the first test, and I didn't hear, you know, anything about that afterwards.
If our menu or our tube...
All right, blah, blah, blah.
...actually in the world, if we don't do this, we get a access and none error. And if... Right, and...
Okay, so back over here, if this is pressed, all right, so oh, that's good. Saber menu item pressed. Ah, yeah, that could be tricky. See, get user widget object. Oh! Well, then that would definitely be the preferred method, then. Cast to UI Saber.
In the main, in this constantly faint.
Blah, blah, blah.
We call our gear, we call.
Alright, and then... come back over here. Let's see. Create event. No, no. Custom event. Button click. I'm assuming that we know. Oh, yeah. We just have to look at my cursor, see where it is, and then we'll know which button it is. So, button clicked. Ooh, I've never heard of Funko. Is it? I'm not sure I know of those little toys either. But awesome. Good for you, man. Impressive. Most impressive.
All are, do a four.
All right, button click. Oh, geez, it wants a... variable. What is that?
For all the buttons, which is in...
variable type. Button. Array. Okay, let me take a look. Ah! Oh, okay. In case anybody is wondering, come on. There we go. These are the toys that Nick is actually talking about. Yeah, he might be hired to do a some of these, I guess. Or at least, some, you know, by the company who makes this. That's awesome, dude. Oh, wow, there's a Jon Snow one. Neat. I mean, these are okay. I don't really see the appeal personally. But, oh god. Okay, now that one is tempting because that actually looks cool. Alrighty. Alrighty, where were we? Oh, yes. Button. Yeah, some of them are nice. It's just overall, I don't particularly like that art style, especially when I'm looking at something I want to buy. If I want something, you know, kind of cool and like little, yeah, I might, you know, get something, you know, kind of like Winston here. Nice little, he looks cute and everything. But you know, if I'm getting something, you know, larger, I prefer something along the more along the lines of this. Yeah, this is really nice quality. Those just look a little too oversimplified for me. I mean, I get why they're popular. I don't quite agree with them being popular, but I get it. And I even get some of the other ones, like the little tiny brick guys. But those things are huge, and I don't like the shape of their heads. That's not to say that I'm not impressed by many of them, so... Alright, so let's see. We need buttons. Buttons, buttons, buttons. Oh, we're doing a for each loop. For each loop. Okay, array element. Slot as canvas slot. Now, right now, I'm just following this guy's tutorial pretty much to the letter. And afterwards, probably off stream, I'll sit down and go through, okay, how can I make this better? And because the guy admits, you know, with this stream, which was only uploaded about a month ago, that he doesn't know anything about this. This is all like new to him.
Stored in an array.
Okay, so event construction. Yeah, I've got all of this just so I can do stuff. Let's actually grab all this. Don't need event tick. I'll pull that this way, do a sequence. So it does all my good stuff that I need. Then we'll go through, set buttons, make array. No, you're not going to let me add more buttons till I fill it up? Okay. Let's see. Anakin, Luke, Vader, and none. All right, get all widgets of class. All widgets of class. I don't see what his class is. Oh.
And this array gets filled on the construct.
Okay, that's
this menu.
The so special thing for him.
And you are three buttons.
So actually, I could probably put this just before my stuff
array.
Over here.
Here in array variable, right? And this is the important part of the blueprint.
But I think we'll just leave that as is.
What it does, it checks if our cursor is in between the position and size of one of the.
All right. So let's see. Get position. Get size. All right, so my cursor, render, transform, get render transform. Now he does a break, but I think we can do, oh, no, he can't. Break widget. Less. Nope, gotta break it again. So yeah, he was doing it the right way. Oh well. Break vector 2Ds. Now he does have, for some reason, index going off way down here, but he's not showing me why. But I'm not seeing anything come back up. And way over here is a branch. And this is leading to an and. A multi-and. Alright, so. If float is. Doesn't really matter which order it is. I don't know why he has it twisted like that. Actually, if that is less than that, yeah, it does matter. So if that equals that, and the y. Oh, no, then. That is less than way down here. Oh, looks like there's some ads. Float plus floats. So, yeah. Looks like Y plus X, I think. It's hard to see. It doesn't make sense that he'd add Y to X. So let's assume that he's doing X plus X. Alright, and that needs to be less than, that's way down here. Ooh, I'm starting to get hungry. Okay, so this is X. And this is that. Huh. Oh, I'm reading this backwards a bit. See, that makes more sense to me. All sorts of spaghetti here. I wish I could clean this up in a nice way, but... Okay, Y there. And Y there.
Button.
Okay,
button.
So, yeah.
We do this by getting...
Ah, I just saw... This is actually being redirected down here. Well, rerouted. I'm gonna reroute myself. Just in case.
Each button as a constant, we check
again,
one of these buttons. We
okay. Set background. Wait, are you, what are you setting that from? Yeah, ray element. Set background color. All right, so there we go. And here we'll set the background color to just pure, let's do kind of a yellow.
One of these buttons, we set the background.
All right, so switch on int.
If it's true, we set it to orange. And from here, coming from here, from the for loop, from the bottom.
Yeah, yeah.
For each one.
Okay. Okay, I think I did that right. check. Yeah, okay. Why is he doing a switch? Probably a better way of doing that is, all right. No, not a select, a, not a, I want a switch. Okay, then I guess that works. Okay, so here it actually does. Here's where it does the functionality. So. Somehow. Oh, here we are. Unclicked button Anakin Saber. All right, let's reorganize these a bit. Saber Anakin goes on one. Saber Vader. Saber Luke. Now see, the buttons are basically his, the button array. It's just his way of being able to go through all this. Wait, array index. So we know which one we are of these. Can I do, click assign? Nope. I just want to do an on click. Bind event to on click. Nope. Get click method. Well, that was an N for once and all from Mass Effect 3, I believe. Yes. Earlier we had 2 Galaxy, which was from Halo 4. Can I get the button name? Get display name, get returns the actual object name. Thank you. That sounds nice. I mean, it's Choplin. Alright, display object name. Switch on string. Ooh, pin names. Here we go. This is actually closer to what I want to do. So, case 0. Is button saber Anakin pressed. So pop this down here. Actually, let's turn that off for right now. Let's see how far this works. Oh, I forgot. I need to launch in VR. Okay. I think I did something wrong. Let's do our new particle system. Call this menu. Particles. Beam. For right now, let's just go with this. Menu particle beam. I'll have to look up on how to create, you know, basically what I want. All right. All right, well, let's take a look then. Shouldn't be too hard. Required. Emitter origin. Spawn. initial velocity. Spawn rate 30, 50, 1 million. Lifetime maximum of 5 seconds. Minimum of 5 seconds. So constant of 5 seconds. We'll take it down to 3. Reduce the velocity down to 75. Or should we just do like 1,000? Start initial velocity. In world space. Apply owner scale. Alright, color over life. That's fine. Initial size, because this feels way too big. Okay, there we go. Let's see how that looks. Okay, that's going definitely the wrong way. So we want it on X, not Z. Spawn rate, spawn, do. There we go. All right, let's come back in here. There should be a way of saying, yes, do not auto activate. Okay, yep, not seeing it, and now we are. Okay, so toggle visibility. Okay. You too, Nick. Yeah, and I hope you do get the job too. Yeah, me too. But good luck, and I hope to hear good news for you soon. All right, pointer right. I sure hope this works. We're just going to toggle the sphere so we know where it is. Because I'm not a big fan of Okay. Let's clear that. Yeah, let's not toggle visibility. Let's set visibility. Is visible. Pointer left. Copy, paste down here. Pointer right. And now. There we go. Oh. Gotta hook those up. Alright. Alright. So, alright, we know that, well, if we ever need particles. Alright, I want to get rid of those particles. There we go. There, I don't know what was going on there. That was just weird. So, no more particles? Good. Alright, event graph. Why is this not setting backgrounds? Is this even working? All right, let's do So let's see if this even works now, because this will at least tell me if the button's being clicked, which I really don't know right now. So, all right, well, it says that the button's being clicked. So I know that that's working. So that's the good news. All right, let's bring this over here. Oh. That never got hooked up. None of those are being hit. Errors? What errors? Access trying to call none. Slot as canvas slot. Get the slot object of the child widget, allowing you to manipulate information. Okay. Return value. from branch on event graph in UI Sabers. So somewhere in here we have a problem. Well, let's just, for right now, set it to positive. Oh, that would be a problem. It's at all of them. Well, at least we know that the button works. All right. Oh, it still had an error? Access none. Trying to read properties. Call get item array. What? Alright, let's see what he was doing. Did I miss something?
And this is
okay, array element, which is what this is, from buttons. Oh, all right, blue, green, and red. There we go. So is that the issue? Let's find out. It switched me over to Anakin. So, and I'm not seeing any errors. So let's see about this now. Now that we have actually plugged in. Okay, we're getting, I'm guessing that's going to be an error. Yep, errors reported. Execute branch. Slot as return value. Call function slot as canvas slot return value. Access none. So, well, what if I just did this? Get slot. Yeah, that's a button, which is can be parented as a reference, as an array. Array of buttons. Maybe that's what I need to do. Set. Background. No, that's right. Access none. Trying to read property. Call function slot as return slot. Yeah, this is. He has slot as canvas slot, which is what we have. And he's reading it from the array element. So why is that not working for us? You know, this is the node that's having problems because it's going back through all this. That's a canvas slot. Alright, let's see what the canvas slot says. Turn that off. Yeah, if I disconnect branch, it seems to work. Doesn't seem to have a problem, although it doesn't tell us anything. So that's somewhat distressing. Maybe I need to put like an in is valid in here. Except it is valid, because, you know. Let's get the display name. See what happens when we do this. Okay, well, Leo. They're all returning the final element. Okay, so that's what that issue is. It's just going through the loop too fast for us to see, you know, each name. Unless let's just keep that. Don't need another one. Let's append. If append or not turn off. There. Every so often I have to tweak that script. Yeah, let's just do that. What is it, the broke? I don't know, there's a lot of things I believe. What are you referring to? Alright, if turned off. Well, I do have German ancestry, so. But I assure you, I am fully American. No, I don't know why I did a Russian accent there. Oh, awesome! Real life Germans from real life Germany. That could be fun. All right, you know what? I'm just going to screw this. Visibility on. I'm not even going to. And it's still not working. Skip that for right now, see what's going on. Huh. It's definitely among my best days, yes. I mean, it's hard to beat the time that I met Mickey Mouse. I do have to say that. But still, you know, a German guy, that's quite fascinating, actually. Somebody from one of my the cities from my heritage. That is fantastic. Would love to learn more. But, alas, it is not to be. Alright, I don't know why we are not getting a display name. Oh, because we're not going directly from there. No wonder. Anakin, Vader, Saber. Yeah, yeah. Good. Get position. Is valid. None of them are valid. Maybe it's not canvas slot. Because well, actually, no, it wouldn't be, because, you know, I actually have mine in a couple of different canvases. So, what I actually want is horizontal box slot. Well, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to use my Vive to create a lightsaber video game. I would love it if it was like real Star Wars, but I am aware that that could be a problem. So I'm not holding out hope for that. But, you know, if I can't do that, then what I'll do is instead create a unique storyline and everything and just do it my way. Get size. I mean, right now, you know, if, let me pop that up. I'll take off my headset real quick. You can see that I've got, you know, droids. They're just standing here right now. These are actually a fan model that I downloaded off the internet. I got them kind of a low quality. It took a while, but, you know, they're still fantastic quality. And then I have a lightsaber that I actually built myself. And then that. Now, the lightsaber sounds, obviously, are from Star Wars, and I'll have to modify that if I do create them. But, you know, we got a nice little lightsaber. It moves about. I can, you know, come here and slash it. You can see light on them. And, you know, I've still got a long ways to go with it. But, you know, right now what I'm trying to do is build a menu system, an interactive menu system, so I can get it... I can change which lightsaber it is and what color the beam is on the fly. if you're asking if I'm a Star Wars fangirl, no, not really. I do like it. But I'm more interested in the fact that there is really nothing good that I can do. Load up and be a freaking Jedi. There is actually a saber game out there, but it is so limited and so very bad. I mean, a beam could be let's say my beam is coming out right here. You know, it's just, you know, kind of like what you saw in the game. I could have a blaster come right here, and it would deflect. It's really, really bad. So, right now I'm just starting to get the basics of it. I'm hoping to have the droid at least animatable by, you know, the next time I do my a stream like for this. But, yeah. Okay, so these are canvas slots. Slot. Border horizontal box, overlay box, uniform grid. All right, so let's see. Get object name, get class, get padding, get size, get vertical alignment. Fill top center, nope. Get vertical padding size, no. Yes, I do. Yeah, I play video games, who doesn't? Let's see. Well, actually quite a few people don't. that slot as uniform grid. No, I don't have CSGO yet. Not sure I want to. Alright, get column and row. Get. Oh, wait, slot first. Get vertical box slot. Get. Horizontal padding. Get size. Vertical alignment. Doesn't let me. Alright, let's see if this works. I doubt it, but you never know. Nope. Let's just try all the slots. Border, canvas. Grid. I don't play any of those, actually. I'm not sure what BO2 is, unless you mean Battlefront 2. But no, I don't play any of those. I play Ark. Slot. See, do I have grid yet? Let's do horizontal. Something, yeah. Horizontal. Vertical. Let's see, slot. Horizontal. Overlay. Slot uniform and finally vertical. Yeah, Ark is a lot of fun. I actually play on a modded server, but oh, no wonder I wasn't getting anything. All right, horizontal slot. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 6, 7, 8. 1. Okay. That's weird. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm guessing. Vertical box, horizontal box. That, this is just weird. Okay, nothing from canvas. What about border? Nope. Grid. Nope. When do I play Ark? Or, well, when is basically whenever I have time. But, yeah, I'm also having a lot of fun with doing this, honestly. Alright, overlay. Uniform. Alright, looks like vertical slot is up. Yeah, okay, so 1, 6, 7, 8, 6, 7, 8. So one, so I'm guessing 1, 6, 7, 8, 6, 7, 8. That's just weird. Alright, so slot. Select. Branch. No, sequence. No, not select. What was the other one? Switch. Select and switch. Okay, so yeah, I do actually have a few games with multiplayer. Let's see, where are they? Well, let's see. I've got Doom, Riders of Icarus, Overwatch, Star Citizen, Ark, and then I have a bunch of other games, but for right now, I had a hard drive crash yesterday, so it's hard for me to, you know, all my stuff is like, you know, so packed away and, you know, crap.
You've got a new follower.
Ah, thank you for following. Where did the other one? Ah, there it is. Okay, so this is the only thing that's returning values. So, size. Get size. Break slant child size. Size rule. Value. Yeah, it's a whole bunch of, you know, sound effects and stuff I just added. So, it's mostly to help me. Alright. Layout, vertical box slot. Set padding, set horizontal alignment, set vertical, set size. No, I don't want slate, though. Let's see, widget. Transform. Well, let's just do get. Get. Location. Get desired size, get visibility. And get desired size, I guess this is the closest we can get. Oh, a B-17 bomber video game? That would be fun. Let's see, location. Position. No. Widget. Transform. Get desired. Get parent. Get visibility. Yeah, his thing, you know. Yeah, if I just had this out here in the canvas on its own, you know, this would, this tutorial I'm following would do is just fine. Yeah, it's always tricky to do stuff like that. But, you know, most of the time you just have to sit down and go, okay, how can I do this? And then you're like, okay, now I know how to do this. Now, how will that help me do this? Oh, okay, so I can just do that to that and that. And, you know, it's really helpful to find and follow tutorials. I mean, that's what I'm doing right now. So I'm just following a tutorial. But unfortunately, I have mine designed in a very different way than his menu. So I actually have, you know, when I do canvas slot, which is what he says, you know, he should be doing, I'm getting very different results. And it's just, you know, it's not working. Because I have mine inside a vertical box, and it's, you know, okay, you have a vertical box. Now what? Well, I need to find out all sorts of things, but it's just not working. That's really frustrating. Hey. Ah. Headset decided to turn off. Well, that thing decided to turn off. Let's see if we can't do this. All right, left, right would be that. Top. And bottom. Well, who knows, maybe this will be it. Maybe this will be the thing that makes it work. Oh, I forgot. Gotta move over there. Yeah, they'll do both. Nope. Okay, so left, so if left is less than, actually no wait, the cursor, this is what we want. If the cursor No, we want, if the cursor is greater than left, there. And okay, let's go. All right, so if it's greater than left and less than right, and it is less than, oh no, greater than, wait, nope. All right, so if X is greater than left, and less than right, and Y is greater than top and less than bottom, then we should be right. Okay, let's take a look. Okay. Get size. Okay, well, I have his size. I don't know. I don't live in Colorado. But I think it's okay. I mean, I've only been there once, so. So maybe I got these backwards? Yeah, this is the crappy part about game development. It's trying to figure out what's going on and why it's not working. I live in Washington State. All right. Read the value of vertical alignment. Hey, you were close. How do you get the positions? parent. Get content slot. Get path name, object name. Cast a widget, select your what? Get slot. What if I cast that? Okay. Yeah, I do, actually. You can see some of my videos on YouTube. Go to YouTube/Kjasi, K-J-A-S-I. Nope, that didn't work. Wrap box slot. Yes, I do. That's where I store all my previous videos. Content slot. Feeling cast would fail. That's dependent on your family. My family always did one present the night before just to keep us calm and sedated, and then we do most of our gifts in the morning. Well, most of our presents in the morning. The gifts are for our enemies. So it just fails outright. Alright, I'm gonna have to basically call it here. I can't get this to work as much as I want it to. I'll have to do more research, find out what's going on, and hopefully we can get this menu working. You know, let's just bugging me that it's not. So, you know. So, just so, you know, everybody can see, let me actually set this over to the right button. There we are. There. And where is my other one? There it is. So, here's my left saber. Here's my right saber. Where'd my headset go? That's alcohol. Oh, hello. No, you're not helpful at all. Oh, it's right here. Oh, yeah. But again, it like I said, it's all dependent on the family. All right, so here's what we've got. We've got our little menu. We can't do anything with it yet, so we'll have to fix that later. As it stands, being able to extend the lightsaber on both of them, see dynamic lighting on them. They don't get dynamic shadows, but I can manually switch over. Cancel. Yeah, well, that's the nice thing about being an American. We're in a huge culture pot, so. I'll stick with Anakin. We'll turn that to Luke. We'll turn that blue. All right. So hopefully this, you know, what you just saw me, oh, you didn't see that at all. I just set up some changes in the default for the character. So hopefully, you know, as you look here, green light on a blue lightsaber. Hopefully we can be able to do that just with the menu here. Blue on the green lightsaber. Again, hopefully we'll do it with the menu, but you know, we don't have to stick to just those. We can also do something like this. Let's have the same two lightsabers. Double the red. Vroom, 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 vroom. Yeah, these guys are not interactable yet. That will be a future thing. I want to get the menus figured out first, and then we will work on that. But, you know, just, you know, from where we're at now, this is just fantastic. Definitely going to keep going forward. I am trying to get the, let me switch back. I'm trying to get these guys animatable, because I would love to start seeing them walk around. And as soon as I can get them at least animatable, they don't have to actually move, although I do want to work on a walk cycle for them. When I can, I'll animate them. I'll get them walking about here. And as soon as we get the menu done, I'm then going to work on the player movement system. As I said earlier in the stream, but I'll say it again just in case. When you move with VR, you need to basically teleport yourself. Trying to... because if you just do movement... you're going to get motion sick. That's almost a guaranteed. That said, I do want to do a little bit of testing with it. I want to, you know, see if I can't get you to move with this, but it follows your head, or maybe it just follows the direction you're holding your sabers. So, you know, if you're holding your sabers, then you start moving about, you know, then that might go a little crazy. And then I'll do some, you know, if I do that, then it'll be one of those things where I average, you know, both your controllers and your headset to figure out which way you're actually moving. But more than likely what I'll do is, you know, little grip buttons on the side, I'll make that, you have to press that down to actually move. And then it follows the grip, the controller that's being gripped. So if I hold down my grip and move, like say, you know, choose that way, it will say, okay, that's the player forward direction. So, you know, that will be player forward, because that's where this controller is going. That's player forward. and he's pressing up on the button. So yeah, we want to move that way. If I were to have that, player would be forward, but you know, if I'm still pressing that direction now, it'll be go, okay, I actually want to strafe to the side. And still keep your head off.
You've got a new follower.
Ah, thank you for following. Let's see. So yeah, there's that. It's all thoughts and things. I mean, the other thought is you're holding your controller, you press the grip buttons, and you dash forward. Or, you know, maybe you just dash forward with, you know, pressing one of these buttons. I don't know. It's all things to consider. And that's all things I'm going to try out. I'm probably going to get very motion sick from some of this, so... I do know that actually forcing the player to move their head when you use the controls gets you very motion sick. Because I was playing a little bit of Project Cars and I did that. I was like, okay, what does this button do? Ah, it's moving my head! I feel motion sick! Stop, stop, stop! So, I gotta reinstall that. Yeah, I had a hard drive failure yesterday, so I lost all my games. And my save games, too! So, we lost... all my save progress for L.A. Noir, which sucks, but alright, that's about it for tonight. We did a long stream, and it is now officially my birthday. Yay! Yeah, it's been my birthday for about 2.5 hours now. Let's see, what am I doing today? I gotta make a lasagna, because that's my dinner. Yeah, for my dinner and occasional, like, Christmas and other things, I will sit down and make a lasagna, because I am damn good at it, and I might make damn good lasagna. It's one of those things where, you know, broke? Technically, it is 2:30 a.m., so yes, tonight. Thank you. Yeah, where I am, it's 2:30 a.m., so it is now technically my birthday. It has been for about 2.5 hours now. And it will be for the next 21.5 hours. So. Ah. Well, good morning, then. I hope you have a good day. I will be streaming here... not tomorrow, because tomorrow's my day off. And even if it was, I'd take the day... Wasn't, I'd take the day off because it's my birthday. Yeah, I will see you all Monday at 9 p.m. Pacific time here in America. So, probably, you know... What, Monday morning? No, Tuesday morning for you. Well, actually, yeah. Early Tuesday morning for you, Broke. All right, that's it. We will probably play Stardew Valley. I might do that tomorrow. I don't normally stream tomorrow, but if I feel up to it and want to, I might do some Stardew Valley. Because I want to play Stardew Valley! All right. Yeah, if I do stream, you can find out about it on my Twitter account, at Kjasi Plays. KJASIPLAYS. Follow me there. I'll let you know what we're doing ahead of time. Usually today I kind of dropped the ball, but you know, I was still trying to get everything going. You know, I'm working with Tip Jar now, so or Stream Jar, so that I was configuring that most of the day. Alrighty, that's it for tonight. Let's stop that music. And where's that other music I had? I had other music. Yeah, stream music. Here we are. Music officially, you know, for the stream. All right. I will see you all Monday or maybe tomorrow. Bye.